What's up, you guys? Today I am back, finally. I've been gone for so long because my marching season has been crazy. I haven't had any time to do anything. So now my marching season's finally over and I have time to make videos for you guys again. So today's video is going to be kind of concert themed because now that marching season is over for me, I think I'm gonna start to do some more concert band stuff, like hairstyles, stuff like that. So today's video, if you can't tell by the title, is some audition tips. But before I get into like chair audition tips and stuff like that, I want to give you guys a little bit of an update on my life and how my marching season went. So this year is my senior year, and it honestly could not have been any better. I did a show with my band called The Four Freedoms, and it is based on the four basic freedoms that are given to us by the Constitution, and it's based off an FDR speech. Well, actually, it's based off of paintings that are based off of an FDR speech, but anyway. The four freedoms are freedom of want, freedom from fear, freedom of worship, and freedom of speech. Yeah. So the show was amazing. I have some videos of that are posted on my band's band's YouTube page, and I will link those down below so you guys can see our show this year, because it was amazing. We went to three competitions and we won first in our class in every single one. Also, we got all of the caption awards for that. So it was a great show and it was a great time, and the band was amazing, and it was just, it was probably the best end to marching band that I could have had, and it's just great. We also beat a band that we haven't beat in 6 years at our last competition, so shout out to that band. If you know that I'm from Saudi, then you know who you are. But yeah, so we did that. Yay! Some more news in my life. I dyed my hair. Yeah, I dyed it more of like a blonde-ish kind of. Let me know if you guys like it. I really like it. I think it looks really nice, and it kind of is an ombre. You just can't really see it because of my hat. But yes, I like my hair. I dyed my hair. Last thing, I really want to make videos for concert season, but I need your guys' help. I need you guys to tell me some videos that you would like to see for concert season. I don't know, I'm kind of running out of ideas. I mean, not running out of ideas, it's just I don't really know how to execute them, so I need some tips from you guys. Tell me what you guys want, and I will do it to the best of my ability. So, with all of that said, let's get on with this video. Alright, so my chair auditions are coming up very soon, and chair auditions at my school are really intense, and especially in my section, the flute section, it is competitive. So my band is split into two bands. That was four. Two. We're split into upper band and lower band. Upper band plays like harder pieces of music. Like, I don't know the range. I forgot it at this time, but they play harder music. Lower band plays easier music. Last year, my junior year, I was in upper band. I was last chair upper band. So yeah. Today, I have some audition tips for you guys. I am like horrible with auditions. I hate auditions. I have serious test anxiety. It not only is in like auditions, but it's also in like ACT standardized tests, stuff like that. Just horrible test anxiety. So I think I have some good tips for you guys to kind of help you guys get over that. It's just stuff that has helped me get over it. My first tip is to practice your scales in the box. This is something that my brand new band director taught us how to do, and basically it's where you go through your scale and you play the first note, and then you go back, play the first note and the second note, and then you play first note, second note, third note, first note, second note, third note, fourth note, first, second, third, fourth, fifth, and just up the scale as high as you need to go, and then once you get to the top, go straight down. So that's in the box, and yeah, it's really helpful, and you can learn your scales really fast with that, so definitely recommend. Second tip is to, if you're working on scales that are in two octaves, I'm a flute player, so I know we have scales that are in three octaves, two octaves. We rarely have a scale that is in just one octave. So if you're working on two octaves, what I think you should do is, well, not what I think you should do, what you should do, because I've done it and it helps, and what you should do is practice the first octave and master the first octave. Like, get it to where you can play it in your sleep, and then work on the second octave, get it to where you can play it in your sleep, and then put them together. And also the in the box thing helps with that, so you can do first octave, and then play it back down, then play it all the way back up, and then do in the box for the second octave, play it back down, then go all the way to the bottom, lower octave, play it all the way up, all the way down. My third tip is to ask for help if you need it. This right here is my audition music for this year, and everybody in my band got the exact same audition music, and that usually isn't how we do it. How we do it is before is we had woodwinds, got one type of music, more like notey stuff and higher octaves, and the low brass and like horns and stuff like that got different kind of easier rhythms and lower notes. Well, this time, this year, we're doing everybody gets the same music. And that's kind of nice because you can practice with your friends who play different instruments, but it also is a lot harder for the brass players because they're not used to playing things like this. So it's easy and hard at the same time, but it's kind of nice because it means that everybody has a fair chance. So what I recommend is that you should definitely ask for help if you need it. It is not, like, you don't have to worry about your pride. I know for me, it's like asking for help. I hate asking for help. But if you need it and you want to be better, then just ask for help. Ask your teacher, assistant band director, ask another person in band who you know is better than you. Just ask them and they'll tell you. And yes, that's what I've done with my music. I had two rhythms that I couldn't get down. I went and asked one person who is better than me, and now I got them down. So don't be afraid to ask for help. Fourth tip is go measure by measure. This is something that we learned in like sixth grade. You play one measure, get that measure down, then play the next measure, and then you play that measure and then that measure. So just go measure by measure, keep adding on, and you will get your part. Now, these next four are some tips that are just kind of things that you can do. The first one is to keep a countdown of when auditions are. My auditions are next Tuesday. So I have a little whiteboard that has... Fourth tip is go measure by measure. This is something that we learned in like sixth grade. You play one measure, get that measure down, then play the next measure, and then you play that measure, and then that measure. So just go measure by measure, keep adding on, and you will get your part. Now, these next four are some tips that are just kind of things that you can do. The first one is to keep a countdown of when auditions are. My auditions are next Tuesday. So I have a little whiteboard that has like 4 days until auditions on it, and that is what I look at. I have it right next to my door, so right whenever I walk out the door, I see it and I know how many days I have and how much time I have to be prepared. Second tip is to wear the same perfume practicing as you are whenever you are in the audition, or wear the same like clothes, like same type of clothes that you are practicing as you are whenever you're in the audition. I've done this for not only auditions, but I've done this for ACT, and it really helps. Just kind of having something that's familiar will calm you down and make it easier for you to focus and do your best. Third tip, this one's kind of a little superstitious, but I mean, I do it. Wear a lucky charm. This is my lucky charm. It's really cute. It has like a little treble clef and an O. It's backwards. It has a treble clef and an O. Super cute, but yeah. That's my lucky charm. I definitely recommend that. Again, just something that's familiar. Third tip, take deep breaths. And I don't mean like, like don't do that. That will give you like an asthma attack. Don't do that. Take a deep breath in through your nose and out through your mouth. What I do is I do 4 counts in, 4 counts out. It really, really helps. And this is something that my grandma told me, and it gets oxygen to your brain and helps you think better if you deep breathe. And do about like 10 of those in a row, and just to calm yourself down, it slows your heart rate, it puts oxygen in your brain, and it just makes everything a lot easier. Last tip is chair auditions are extremely, extremely competitive. Trust me, I know. Especially in woodwinds in my band, it's hardcore. So my tip is don't let anybody get to you. I know that things can get really competitive, but you have to keep in mind that you're all in the same band. You all are a family, and you can't let just somebody getting a chair above you get to you. if you did your best and you got the chair that you got, then there's nothing more that you could do. You don't need to beat yourself up about it, and you definitely don't need to let other people get into your head and make you think that you're not good enough. That is probably the worst thing that you could do. I know from experience, it's horrible whenever you listen to people who are saying mean things. Just don't do it. Block them out. Focus on what you gotta do and try your hardest. So those are all of the tips that I have for you guys for chair auditions. I hope that you all do very, very well in your chair auditions. I hope you get the chair that you want. And yeah, wish me luck on my chair auditions that are Tuesday. We'll see how it goes. I'll let you guys know. But I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I will see you guys in my next one. Bye!